So your book was published before this Common Prosperity Initiative. Has your assessment of the future of China's cashless revolution changed since then? Today, if the investor is looking at the fintech industry in China, what are the risks and opportunities an investor should take note of?
So there's a lot less space for disruptive innovation than there was even 2 years ago. I would say I do have a lot of the post-Jack Ma speech crackdown and shift in regulation, including backlash against big tech companies, in the book. And from a common prosperity perspective, I think the most important element to consider is that the government really wants to reduce the take rate, the amount of that credit ends up costing, and the amount that technology companies are able to charge the traditional financial system for providing technology services. And that obviously puts downward pressure on margins. The other element is the increased focus on data security and data privacy, and that makes it harder to monetize the data collection involved in finance and could end up leading to a much smaller market for fintech, especially credit, than would otherwise be the case.
Thanks for watching. You can find out more about China's business and economic landscape by subscribing to our newsletter, joining our premium Chinese business intelligence database, and of course, watching this show. Find out how to do all of that in the summary section of this video.